horse flying out of the blue corner to my right. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall. Official weight, 84 kilograms. Tonight, he is making his mixed martial arts debut, representing the White Ministry Grimsby and Barney out of Grimsby. Ladies and gentlemen, here it is.
Right, here we go. We have three rounds of action. Semi-pros kick it off between Josh Dilcock out of the red corner wearing the black trunks. Wearing the camouflage is Abdul Mawa. Immediately pressing the action is Josh Dilcock. Dilcock looking and a nice takedown for Dilcock. And spinning around is Mawa. We have reversing the positions and tagging the body is Mawa. Now Mawa looks for a north-south choke, but a nice job to prevent it is Josh Dilcock. Mawa is an animal. Now on the back trying to pound away. What back-and-forth action we have here at the bonus arena for 10th Legion Championship fighting 6 Gates of Fire. And again, now Mawa gets into the guard. Mawa on top looking a pound away on Josh Dilcock. Oh, Bull Mawa just trying to, he has side control now. This is somewhere that Josh Dilcock does not want to be. You know, Bull Mawa making his MMA debut, trains at the Fight Ministry in Grimsby. Retail manager by day, trains under Neil Laws. Meanwhile, Josh Dilcock, 20 years of age, has been doing Thai boxing and MMA for about 2.5 years. He told me last night that he wants a first round knockout. So far, it is all Abdul Mawa. Abdul Mawa still having side control. Referee Trevor Mitchell right there looking for inactivity. But Abdul Mawa is just doing a nice job of staying active, looking for a key lock, just kind of pressuring and sizing up and softening up Josh Dilcock. In the corner of Josh Dilcock, Craig Lawrence. Lawrence is also a renowned official and owns his own gym along with being a fireman. And Trevor Mitchell telling him they need to pick up their action. And Abdul Mawa tagging on the side of the body of Josh Dilcock. And a hard right hand that lands for Mawa. Pushing him off is Josh Dilcock. But immediately he is like just glued to the body is Abdul Mawa. Mawa is like a bull just rushing in and just overpowering Josh Dilcock. And that is the end of round one. What a round it was as Abdul Mawa in control of Josh Dilcock as we get ready for the second round. Josh Dilcock wearing the black trunks. He is out of the red corner. Wearing the camouflage out of the blue is Abdul Mawa. For one, I would have to give it to Mawa just based on his ability to control Josh Dilcock. Here we go, second round, semi-professional middleweight division. And Mawa's coming in. Nice left hand, followed by a right. And Dilcock is backpedaling. A front kick by Dilcock, but that right hand that landed from Mawa clearly caught the attention of Josh Dilcock. He's going for a takedown now. Nice job to maintain his vertical base. Mawa still going for that single leg takedown. He picks him up and drops him. Mawa tries to pop up, but it's Dilcock now who is reversing the tables in the second round. Whatever Craig Lawrence's trainer told him must have paid dividends. Now Mawa gets to his feet. Hit in the back now. Josh Dilcock. He's looking for a switch. Is Mawa. And oh, belly to back suplex. What a suplex and what a display of strength here at the Bonus Arena. That was textbook. And now looking for a triangle was Mawa. He just pushes him off as to say, let's go again. Mawa trying to step in, a leg kick, a front kick, a right hand that misses, going for a takedown. Again, Dilcock pressing Mawa against the cage. What a fight we have. The semi-pros are kicking it off and setting a tremendous speed. Now a knee right through the guard. And now an uppercut by Mawa. Both guys are trading shots. Some knees by Mawa, followed by some dirty boxing. This is textbook dirty boxing, if I ever saw such a thing, and I believe the nose is bloody of Dilcock, and he takes him down, does Mawa. And I believe something happened there. Referee Trevor Mitchell, who's done many shows all over this great country, is calling for time. Dilcock has his back on the canvas, now gets up. And listen to the fans, they are right behind Josh Dilcock from the Selby Martial Arts Center in Selby.